channel. Today we will discuss how to find out the oxidation number of a compound. For example, we have two atoms A and B, and there is a single bond. If electronegativity of B is higher than that of A, then B will attract this bond pair towards itself. So charge on B is -1 and charge on A is +1. But if there is a double bond between A and B, again electronegativity of B is higher than that of A. Now charge distribution will be, both bond pair will attract towards B. So charge on B is -2, charge on A is +2. And if we have triple bond between A and B, and again electronegativity of B is higher than that of A, then charge distribution will be, all these three bond pair will be attracted towards B. But if we have same type of atoms A and A, now electronegativity of both A is same. So in this case, there will be no charge distribution. Charge on A is 0, charge on another A is 0. By this we can find out the oxidation number of various compounds. For example, we have to find out the oxidation state of a sulfur. So charge on hydrogen is +2. Why +2? Because there are two atoms. -8. Charge on one oxygen is -2, and we have four atoms, so total charge is -8. X equal to +6. But in some compounds, this oxidation number method failed, and then we have to understand the structure also. So first compound is H2SO5. Its common name is caro acid. If we find out the oxidation number with the X method, charge on sulfur is +8. But as we know, sulfur has only 6 valence electrons, so its maximum oxidation number can be +6 only. But if we have solved this, we obtain a +8. So now we have to understand the structure of H2SO5. There are three atoms, hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen. Oxygen is most electronegative among these three, so it will show negative charge, and both these will show positive charge. So we have 6 valence electrons of sulfur. Now these two hydrogen will share electron with the oxygen, because oxygen is more electronegative. So there will be a 2 OH bond also. So we share these electrons with the oxygen. By this double bond, charge on sulfur is +2. By this bond, charge on sulfur is +2. By this +1, and by this +1. So total charge is +6. But now we have 2 hydrogen also. Now we have to add 1 oxygen more and 1 hydrogen more. So there will be oxy linkage. One electron is shared by these oxygen. So by this sharing, there will be no charge. This oxygen will obtain only -1 charge from this bond. Now this oxygen is -2. This oxygen again will obtain -1 charge from this bond only. Now we can solve by x method. We can see there are 3 oxygen which has minus 2 charge and there are 2 oxygen which has minus 1 charge. So plus 2 plus x. 3 oxygen are showing minus 2 charge. So plus 3 into minus 2 plus 2 oxygen atoms are showing minus 1 charge. So oxidation state of sulfur is plus 6 instead of plus 8. We can understand it by structure only. Right? Next compound is chromium pentoxide. If we find out the oxidation number by X method, then charge on chromium must be plus 10, but chromium can show maximum oxidation state of plus 6 only. So again we have to understand the structure, how 5 electrons are, how 5 oxygen atoms are attached with the chromium. Chromium can show maximum oxidation state plus 6 only. So these two electrons are shared with one oxygen. Right? But oxygen forms two bond, but these four oxygen atom has formed a one bond only. So these are interlinked with each other. Now each oxygen is showing double bond, two bonds are formed. Now charge distribution by this bond plus 2 and by chromium oxygen single bond, charge on chromium is plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So total charge is plus 6 and there are 4 oxygen atoms which are showing minus 1 oxidation state. So if we solve by X method again, X minus 2 plus 4 into minus 1. 4 oxygen atoms are showing minus 1 charge. So total charge is plus 6. This is again exceptional of a X method. So we have to understand the structure. Third compound is H2S2O8. Now it is known as Marshall acid. So if we solve it and find out the oxidation state, now sulfur is showing plus 1 plus 7 oxidation state. But as we know, it can show maximum oxidation state plus 6 only. So there is again oxy linkage will be present in H2S2O8. Oxy linkage means bond of oxygen with the oxygen. So now we have 2 sulfur. This is the structure for a Marshall acid. There is again oxy linkage. Now we can understand the charge distribution. By this bond, plus 2. By this bond, plus 2. By this bond, plus 1. By this bond, plus 1. So total charge is plus 6. And again for this sulfur, total charge is plus 6. Plus 2, plus 2, plus 1. Now there are 2 oxygens which are showing a minus 1 charge. Because of this sharing of electron, there will be no charge distribution. So this oxygen is minus 1, this is minus 1. All other are minus 2. So we can solve by X method again. Plus 2, plus 2x. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 oxygens. oxygen are showing. Sorry, 6 oxygens are showing minus 2 charge. And 2 oxygen atoms are showing minus 1 charge. So this throughput 2x minus 12 equal to 0, x equal to plus 6. So you have to understand the structure of compound also, and by structure we can understand the correct oxidation number for exceptional cases, right? That is for exceptional cases. Thank you.